Imagine a world where every vehicle you drive is made of glass. Perfect visibility everywhere you look without any blind spots at all. Well, this is the Honeywell 360 display, a revolutionary device that uses mixed reality to give drivers a 360-degree view of the world around them. Well, today I'm out here in the desert to put this product to the test and see if I can drive this 5-ton Hummer without looking out the windows at all.
Whoa, big bump.
This is our H1 Hummer. We've integrated our 360 helmet mounted display into that. And as you can see from it, it looks like a military vehicle, but also a commercial. So we're able to use that and test out both applications and really get a sense for that off-road capability.
So my first question is really, how does this thing work? I mean, I see the cameras and the sensors all around, but how is that giving the driver that 360-degree look?
All right, so if you see the different cameras, what they do is they pull it in. Our software then stitches this 360 view dome that gives you this ability to look around you and even with this handy bumper camera to do some precision navigation driving.
So when I see this tech, it makes me think of some of the top-down views consumer cars have or some of the rear backup cameras. I imagine some of that is similar, right?
Right. It's a bit of a foundation, but what we've done is taken it to the next level and really given you that full 360 view as you look around. Instead of just staring at a flat screen, you can naturally move your head like you would want to do when you're driving or trying to navigate something.
So I know you mentioned the military aspects for this thing, and I can definitely see a soldier in like a windowless tank really being able to use this headset to see around. But then my mind goes to what happens on the battlefield if one of these cameras or sensors gets hit with shrapnel or some sort of explosive and goes down. What kind of backup systems are in place?
So what we've designed into the system is that if you do lose a camera, the system will compensate for it, but it also sends an alert to the driver that says, hey, you're not operating at full capability. So there's this graceful degradation. And then we also work with the vehicle OEMs to go ahead and provide ballistic protection or even locations on the vehicle to help protect that from those types of threats.
So along those same lines, what about lag? Because I'm just imagining someone driving this, they're under a headset and display. Like if you see any sort of lag in the image, I mean, I imagine that could be pretty dangerous, right?
Right, so that's what we have as the key to our system. It's the ultra low latency so that when you move your head or snap your head to position, the image is there. And when you get that lag, that's what causes nausea and that's what we don't have and that's the problem we solved.
Now, since this is a wearable headset, I imagine you guys are able to do some like heads-up display technology as well, where really the driver then isn't having to get distracted by looking down at their dash or console for different information, because it's really all right there.
Exactly. We provide the driver with all the information they need to operate the vehicle safely and navigate. So for example, speed, direction, embedded symbology, all those things so they can focus on their primary task of driving and operating the vehicle.
I'm definitely excited to put this thing to the test. I'm normally a pretty good driver, although I've never driven without any windows, so we'll see how that goes. But yeah, this should be fun.
All right, well, let's get you kitted up and let's start your leap of faith into the technology.
So what I've been told is that pretty much anyone can just pick this up, put it on, and be ready to drive in just a matter of minutes. Now, I'll of course be the judge of that myself, but as you can see, the display is attached to this helmet, so once you put it on, you just flip this visor down, and then boom, you can see all the terrain and everything around you. Should be pretty sweet, so I'm gonna go ahead, get in here, get situated, strapped in, and ready to go for our little demo.
Now that you've seen the overview of the vehicle, we're gonna get you kitted up with the helmet, so I'd like you to put the helmet on for safety reasons, but also feel like a soldier.
I gotcha, okay.
So I don't know if you've worn helmets before.
Well, how did I do? I think chin strap, right?
Chin strap, absolute chin strap, but you want it to sit stable on there.
Sure, okay, yeah, it feels good.
And a way to check that is just go ahead and look up. You'll see a few windows and different options. Go ahead, look around a little bit, get a comfort feel, and then also look down.
Yeah, so this is crazy. So when you look up, you're actually seeing like the rear view mirror I see. So we got straight behind us and then over the right and left. And then we've got the top down view, which is crazy. And then the fact that you can literally look down and see below you, that's gonna be crazy. I hear you guys say that anyone can pretty much drive this. So you
that's
think
right.
I have what it takes?
I mean, you just went through the whole training. So I'd like you to go ahead and test this out. You give me the thumbs up and well, let's go.
Let's test it out. Let's do it.
Are you ready for your leap of faith moment? That's what we call when we tell someone, put it in drive, trust the technology, you can see. And it's okay if you only go 1 or 2 miles per hour till you get comfortable.
but in a couple of minutes, you'll be doing 25, 30, 40 miles per hour. Just don't roll the vehicle on us.
All right, well, here we go, putting it in drive. And we are off. Whoa. Okay, haven't crashed yet, doing good so far. Okay, so first impressions, this thing definitely works. It's like an enhanced version of what you'd see out of a normal car windshield, but in this case, you really can see everything around you. So, feeling pretty comfortable so far. All right, gonna swing a left here. Come on, Hummer. Now, Gerhard, you mentioned earlier that the footage the viewers are seeing is probably really shaky right now, but what I'm seeing is actually buttery smooth, and that's because the camera's recording my head movements, right?
Right, so what you're actually doing is you're getting stereoscopic vision, meaning that each of your eyes gets fit in an image just like it does in the real world to give you that natural vision feel, so that what your eyes see and your body feels the motion, your brain senses as normal. And when the two don't correspond, your brain tells you, stop doing it, I'm gonna make you nauseous.
Yeah, motion sickness is definitely something I have dealt with in the different aircraft and vehicles I've been on, but I'll be honest, I'm feeling pretty good right now. So yeah, product's doing a good job. So I see why the learning curve is pretty much non-existent. I mean, I just jumped right into this thing and haven't crashed yet. Now I will say it does take a little bit of getting used to, like when you're turning, you kind of have to decide, whoa, big bump. If you want to look straight or left, but really, the vision you get from this thing is probably more than your typical consumer car. So I think that's probably why anyone can just hop in this thing and have some success. Now, Gerhard, I know we've talked about some of the military uses for this technology, but really, you can put this, I assume, anywhere. Consumer vehicles, boats, airplanes. Where do you really see the future of this technology going?
Well, first off, you know, it's for limited visibility where it's hard to see environments. So think commercial mining. They're driving those large trucks that they can't see around.
Yeah.
Think of a tugboat operator trying to push a ship into a harbor. And all those other different applications, fire or first responders, where they don't know what's outside of them or if they can't see around the vehicle because of smoke and other things. So I think it really gives you a huge opportunity in all those different areas on the commercial side.
Yeah, I'm imagining that soldier in like a windowless tank that can see all around them. Like you said, the mining industry, so pretty much any vehicle, any sort of instance where you have rugged terrain, this kind of like eliminates, you know, all of those vision concerns with this headset.
All right, Sam, you've done well up to this point, so now let's take you up a little bit of a challenging climb. Let's see if you can do it. I think you can.
I think I can too. Big bump. Okay. Let's go. There we go. All right.
So one thing you may have noticed too is the 3D depth perception, and that's the difference of what we have here is when you have a flat screen, you can't tell depth perception, so
yeah.
You're able to see that there was a cliff that we wanted to avoid, which I'm very happy you did, by
the way. Yeah, exactly. I'm glad we did too. All right, big turn here. Now, you know what this technology really reminds me of is kind of what they have in the new F-35 fighter jet helmet, right? So the fighter pilots can kind of see through the ground, which helps them land in like aircraft carriers. It's kind of similar tech to that, huh?
It is similar, but a little bit more complex and harder to solve because you're driving on the ground and you can tell from here from the bumps and the gyrations, whereas if you're flying, it's a relatively stable flight path. Whereas here on the ground, you've got potholes, things you're trying to avoid and maneuver around. And that is definitely a technology challenge that we solved with this.
Right.
All right, Sam, why don't you go ahead and take us back to our starting point. You did a great job on the course. I really appreciate that you took that leap of faith.
Thank you. Yeah, this was super fun. I'll swing us back into position here. And yeah, we can do a little debrief, but this was awesome.
All right, Sam, what did you think?
Well, the fact that I was able to kind of just hop in there and give it a go without much training was super cool. I will say, at least on my end, I felt like I was in complete control. Hopefully you felt something similar. But really, I'm excited with where this technology could go. I mean, we talked about the applications in airplanes, boats, mining equipment. Who knows where it's going to end up, but it's exciting.
All right, well, congratulations. You've passed the Honeywell 360 display driver's course.
Oh my gosh.
You're officially licensed.
Congratulations on completing windowless driver training. I don't know when I'm gonna use this, but I appreciate it.
Okay, but don't show it to a state trooper. He won't like it.
Will do. Thanks so much, everyone, for hanging out on this one. I hope you learned something new. And I'll catch you next time. All right.